So you've alluded to one advantage of immunotherapy, which is it's very targeted. What are some other advantages you would consider over other systemic treatments?
The immune system recognizes, as we said, what is self and not self. Right. And therefore, specificity is the most important character of the immune system. Namely, it attacks the cancer cells and spares normal cells,
sure.
Number one.
Right.
Number two, memory. Mm-hmm. Memory cells, once a cell has been educated to attack that specific cancer cells, it doesn't disappear.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like short-lived cells. These are memory cells that live for years, and any time cancer starts working and developing some other alternate mechanism, the immune system recognizes, and the memory system has the, is there to reject the cancer again. So micrometastasis in the future and memory cells are an important feature. Finally, it's the cancer changes consistently.
Mm-hmm.
Heterogeneity is changing.
Mm-hmm.
The immune system does not care how the cancer changes.
Mm-hmm.
The immune system knows that this is a foreign. So as long as the changes are happening, it might create a problem for all the targeted cancer therapy.
Right.
Because targeted cancer therapy go against a specific target.
Right.
However, here, in this particular case, whether it changes or doesn't change, doesn't make any difference. The immune system looking at it is a foreign. So the specificity, the memory, and the heterogeneity, and the durability of the responses. That's what it is. What it means, once you have achieved a response with immunotherapy, it stays there for a long time. I have patients that are now 2 decades after metastatic kidney cancer, still responding. The question is how to increase that percentage
right.
of patients.
So what do you consider the most exciting area now where immunotherapy would be most effective?
I think if you ask me today, in May of 2014, it's a very relevant question, because kidney cancer for years was the best tumor in urology for immunotherapy. In addition, there was superficial bladder tumor with BCG. However, as of this week, nobody has seen yet the entire data, but the new abstract appeared from ASCO.
Mm-hmm.
And so in quickly reviewing, and it was only 2 days ago, quickly reviewing, the much anticipated data from the new immunotherapy, which is called anti-PD-L1. For whatever it is, it's an immunotherapy, it's an antibody that attacks cancer cells against bladder cancer. And this is actually a small study with only about 40 patients, but it's the first time that it shows the power of immunotherapy in eradicating bladder cancer metastatic in patients who failed. 70% of these patients in that group failed prior treatment for their metastatic kidney cancer. The response rate was quite astounding, was about 50%. According to the abstract, there is one complete responder, seven or nine partial responses. So it means that the next generation of effort in entire of oncology, definitely with anti-PD-L1, will go to advanced bladder cancer that failed surgery. So after cystectomy, the patient develops metastatic disease.
Mm-hmm.
I think eventually, if it pans out the way the small study showed here, in a few years from now, we'll see the first line therapy, even before chemotherapy, we'll see immunotherapy replacing it.